Good morning, guys. Well, me and my little buck buster. Leave it on. Leave it on. No, no. Oh, he was wearing it so well, too. Here you go. No, no. No, no. No, no. Leave it on. Don't you look cute? No. We are gonna go out to Grandma's, and then me and Jason and John are gonna meet up, and we're gonna go clear some shooting lanes and move some stands today. It'll be a day of no hunting. Just gonna take it easy and get some stuff done. I am feeling under the weather. I got a terribly sore throat, sneezing, coughing, runny nose, you name it. Nope, 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 nope. Oh, you little shit. All right, let's get started. Yeah, last time was pretty rough. Oh my God, it started about 9:30 at night. I just couldn't stop sneezing, so I took an allergy pill. That didn't make any difference at all. I thought it was allergies, but nope, I'm sick. And I'm going out to the woods to do all sorts of different shit. But if I don't go, nobody will. Yeah, first it's just gonna be me and Jason working out there. I'm not gonna be doing too much, probably just hauling the foliage with the trailer, that'll be about it. And then Jason wants to move his deer stand. I don't know why. Oh, by the way. No, I'm gonna tell you guys after you see the next hunting video, which should be up in about 2 hours. Well, it doesn't matter, you guys are gonna see this probably not till tomorrow anyway. See, I'm delirious because I'm sick. Yeah, it's not like I'm live webcasting or anything. Yeah, I'll clear it up tomorrow. But anyway, so I know a lot of you are gonna be like, why are you going out there at this time? Well, this is the only time we've got to go, because you know it's really hard to get John to get out there and help. And when he is motivated, you know, it's good. Now wait until he motivates himself, and then we're like, okay, we're golden. We're gonna go out there and we're gonna get started and move stuff and, you know, and everything. But you can't get him out there unless he's motivated. And he's a big part of the help that I need, even if he is old and feeble. As for Jason, Jason's got to leave for work at 1 o'clock, so, you know, I only got him for a couple of hours. And, but as I was saying, he wants to move his deer stand. I don't think he should. I think he should just stick it out, because that spot produces deer like crazy. And you never know, because it's a main thoroughfare. Going both north and south, east and west. I mean, that's one of the places, I guess, you know, if he moves, then maybe I'll take it. I don't know. Sorry, guys. I'm really just babbling here. My throat is just killing me. Shit, guys, the one time I don't bring my gun with me, and we've got this little guy just taunting me. Oh, that's all right. Let them live. All right, so we're walking down the ATV trail down onto the marsh trail. Well, we're on the marsh trail, coming down into it further up here. Last night I saw a lot of deer come out of this area right here, and what I was thinking, if it's even possible, is maybe moving my stand in this general vicinity here, but I'm not sure I'm going to yet. So if you look, you probably can't see it because the lens is so wide, but my stand is right there where I'm pointing, and I'm gonna knock down some trees and shit for shooting paths. Alright, I got that cleared out pretty good. Right there's the stand. So basically, if a deer stands in this one spot, I'm gonna be shot. There's also, they came through up here. They saw, I just happened to see their tails, like right at the edge, right at the edge of the woods here. That's when I saw them turn onto this trail. So they're coming through somewhere over here. But I'm gonna take a look down here real quick. I know there's a big trail right here coming up. Yeah, right there. Sure. They turn onto this, onto the marsh trail. And I'm right over here. In this thicket right here, I can see them through that. So I'm gonna cut that down today. Providing I have enough energy for it. Trying to get up the other side of the creek with the trailer and stuck. Right, try and reverse. I don't have any brakes. Oh god. I can't get up the hill.
Can't believe that. You ain't got much weight in there. Look at that fucking trailer. It's fucking
heavy. Yeah, the trailer's heavy, yeah.
Where's that gonna go?
What? It's right there. I must have rolled back about 5 times. All the way back into the creek.
Ha 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 ha!
should go.
So we're at the marsh stand now. Well, I am. John is lagging behind. And it's the stand right there. And it's a good stand. It's just that it's uncomfortable to sit in because it, the way the branches.
If you keep up, you know!
But the way the branch leans, it really makes it awkward to sit in. So we're just gonna move it around and maybe move it to this tree right here. All right, so we got the stand moved. And then John went all work crazy and cleared all about 20 yards to the west or east. So now that big popple in the back, we can see clearly. And beds everywhere. I mean, it must have been 10 beds, right? Or more beds, and there is deer trail upon deer trail upon deer trail, beds upon beds. It's just crazy. Big beds too, yeah. So I'm gonna give this stand like a 4 or 5 days, and I'm gonna come back here and sit. Might be a good morning stand.
I was gonna say it'd be awful.
Thank you.
I guess we can't get back there. Oh, it goes, it sneaks through there. Yeah, it's really bad.
Yeah, around that whole thing. Yeah, I was nice to get back to the other stairs because something got stuck on. I was like, fuck that.
I'll show you. There's another road. Hold on. John's still back there screwing around doing stuff. I don't know what he's doing. But I gotta get the kids home and feed them and myself. I haven't eaten anything today. All I've had is cough drops. And I'm just feeling completely wiped out. Did a lot of work. We cleared a couple of shooting paths over by John's deer stand. We diverted a couple of trails. Then we went over to the marsh stand, and you guys saw that, and we moved that stand over to face directly east, but I don't know if that's a good idea considering, you know, with the sunrise and whatnot. And then, we were going to go to the south stand, but we got freaking buried, or I got buried, and John got all pissy about it. So we turned around and headed back, and we stopped at my new stand there, and we cut a shooting lane directly north of the stand where I saw that deer walking through yesterday. And now it's just wide open. I mean, well, not wide open, but there is a hell of a nice shooting path through there. Unfortunately, it's 50 yards plus from my stand to that trail, so I probably won't be taking any photos, any shots, I mean. And after that, I'm like, dude, I told him, like, I gotta go, man. My arm is killing me. I'm tired. I'm starving. I feel like shit. And he's like, all right, I'll be right behind you. And I never saw him again. He's still out in the woods cutting wood. End up killing himself back there. He's got a lot of problems with his back, his knee, his shoulders. He's gonna be crying tomorrow, I guarantee it, and so will I, but I guess it's part of getting old. I'm gonna give the woods about 2 or 3 days to cool off, calm down, maybe a day. I think a day, yeah. I don't want to miss this weather. It's perfect for it. Deer are moving. I think I'll just give it tomorrow and then I'll go out. And I really would like to sit over in the marsh, stand, but I don't know. It's kind of hard to get to. And then I feel like I might be missing out on my new stand. I'll sit where the wind puts me. I want that. If the wind is blowing from the east, I'm going to sit in the marsh stand. If the wind is blowing from the south, I'm going to sit in the new leaning stand. So
next time, guys. I will talk to you later.